Hello everybody and welcome again to this training session. So today we will see some financial accounting. So first of all, this video will be an introduction to this training. So first of all, we will see why financial information is important. So it is necessary for decision making, and in order to make informed and good decisions, a person should understand the past and the present performance of corporations. So the demand for financial accounting information is also growing. So we will see the stewardship, investments and credit decisions, contracting, performance evaluation, regulation, and finally pricing and negotiation. So, what is business? Business is all the activities that are necessary to provide the members of an economic system with goods and services. So, this includes providing goods or products, manufacturing products, distributing goods, either wholesale or retail, and providing services as well. So, to organize a business, there are three types of business organizations. We have sole proprietorships, partnerships, and corporations. So, let's begin with the sole proprietorship. It's entreprise individuelle in French. So, it's all about business that is owned by one person, and the economic entity concept for accounting purposes, the owner must keep personal finances separate from those of the business. Also, for tax purposes, the business does not pay income tax because it is not separate from its owner. There is an unlimited liability, so the owner is responsible for all the debts of the business, and the life of the business is limited as well. For a partnership, c'est société des personnes. A partnership is a business owned by two or more individuals. Here we talk about partners. And obviously, an agreement between two or more partners is needed to form a partnership. For tax purposes, the business does not pay income tax since it's not legally separate from its owners. For the unlimited liability, owners are responsible for all the debts of the business, and there is a limited life as well. We have here corporation, or in French, Société de Capitaux. So a corporation is a separate legal entity. It is legally separate and distinct from its owners. I mean here, it's responsible for its own acts and own debts. So its owners are called shareholders or stockholders, because they hold shares of stock, and a corporation acts through its managers, I mean here legal agents. And also it pays income tax, limited liability, and unlimited life as well. For the corporation, we have publicly held. So this is a stock exchange, or also called the stock market. So easy for transfer of ownership, and there is an ability to raise a large amount of money in a short period of time. And here we are talking about a stock and a bond. So a stock is a certificate that acts as evidence of ownership in a corporation, and the bond is a certificate that represents a percentage of the firm's debts. And it is a compromise by the company to repay a certain amount of money in the future. To organize a business, so let's recapitulate all what we have seen so far. So who owns the business in a sole proprietorship? So it's the manager in partnership, they are partners, and for the corporation, it's the shareholders. So now are managers and owners separate? No, and in sole and partnership, but in the corporation it is usually separate as well. What is the owner's liability? So it's unlimited for both cases, but limited in corporation. Are the owner and business taxed separately? No, and yes in the corporation. So here is the corporate structure. So just recapitulation of what we have seen so far. So for sole proprietorships and partnerships, we have unlimited liability and personal tax on profits. And for the corporation, we have limited liability and corporate tax on profits and personal tax on dividends. For the non-business entities, so usually they are organized for a purpose other than profit. They exist to meet certain needs of society, for example, a service like government, schools, hospitals, non-government and charitable organizations and so on. There is also a lack of an identifiable owner. And also they still need financial information to monitor progress toward their goals. The nature of business activity, so it could be categorized into three types, for example, financing, investing and operating. For the financing activity, money is needed to begin and continue a business. And also it is invested in capital or capital stock, and also it's permanent, I mean it does not need to be repaid, and contributors are called stockholders and are the owners of the corporation. For the borrowed capital, it's a loan that must be repaid eventually, so it's a liability and it's an obligation of the business. Also, the corporation is the debtor when they borrow, I mean here incur liabilities. So lenders are called creditors, and they don't provide permanent financing to the business, and creditors expect to be repaid. For investing activities, so once funds are generated from creditors and stockholders, money is available to acquire assets, and assets of a business are properties and economic resources owned by the business, so they are future economic benefits to a business, and they are in terms of cash, buildings and equipment. So for operating activities, once funds are obtained from financing activities and investments are made in productive assets, a business is ready to begin operations, and operating activities are day-to-day activities involved in the selling and buying of goods and services. And here we are talking about the revenue and the expense. So as a summary of what we have seen in this video, what is business? And we have seen the types of organization that engage in business and the several activities that businesses conduct.